Hello, this clip is to demonstrate how to calculate z-scores in the percentile rank. So suppose I survey every single woman and man in the US for their height. So the data should look like this. So look at this. This is the frequency in terms of how many people. And this is the height in terms of inches. And this is separate men from women and focus on men. We will expect a normal distribution with not a lot of people extremely short or tall, most of the people around average. This is normal distribution. Now, with this data in hand, this assume the mean, the average height for American men is 70 inches, and the standard deviation, SD, is 5 inches. If that's the case, suppose Adam is 75 inches tall. Now, how tall is he exactly when he compared to other people? Is he considered really, really tall or just a little bit tall? Now, in order to answer this question, we need to first figure out how far away this value of 75 is from the mean in terms of standard deviation. Okay, so in other words, how many standard deviation is 75 away from the mean? See, what we're doing right now is converting the value of 75 into a z-score. This is how you calculate z-score. Right. Now, the process of converting a raw score, in this case 75, into a z-score is called standardization. Okay. Now, to calculate the z-score, we use this formula right here. We use some of this is 75, this is x, subtract the mean, which is 70, and then divide it by SD, which is 5. Okay, so let's try to do that. Okay, 75 subtract 70, and then the whole thing divided by 5. So 5 divided by 5, easy, it should be 1. All right, so the z-score of 75 is 1. The next step for us is to figure out how big is the area between the mean 70 and 75? So, sorry, this area. Okay. Now, luckily, statisticians they have done that for us. So, all we need to do is to look at something called the Z table, which is at the end of your book, Appendix B. Let me show you here. So you look at this table, this column here, right, is z-score. And the column next to the z-score is the percentage. So we just calculate the z-score is 1. So we need to find 1. This is not enough. It's z-score right here. 34.13. That means this area is 34.13% compared to the whole area. Okay. And so, how tall exactly is Adam compared to other people? In other words, how many people are shorter than 75 inches? Now, we know this area already in terms of percentage. So, how about this area? This must be 50% because it's below the mean. So, all we need to do is this. 50 plus 34.13. It's 84.13%. That means 84.13% of men are shorter than 75 inches. In other words, atoms can be considered quite tall. Let's practice another value. So suppose Zach is shorter. He is only 66 inches tall. How about that? Okay, 66. So how tall exactly is he compared to the whole population? Okay, in order to figure that out, first, let's calculate the z-score. So it should be 66 minus 70, then divided by 5. So it is negative 4 divided by 5. The answer should be negative 0.8. Now the next step is to find out the z-score. Now you might ask, well, I don't see any negative value right here. That's okay, let me show you. Let's just find this positive value, 0.80. Then this percentage is 28.81. That means this area right here, okay, is here, right here, is 28.81% compared to the whole population, only this area. So now if we want to ask how many people in terms of percentage are shorter than 66 inches, see, this is 50%. So all we need to do is use 50 to subtract 28.81. And what would be the answer? Okay, let's ask calculator. 58 minus 28.81. Oh, 21.19. That means Zach is only taller than 21.19% of the population.